friends. Today's new class is a Yinyasa with weights. Actually, just one weight for today for the particular exercises. One weight required. But if you wanted to have different options as far as how heavy you go, of course that's fine. I'm using a 10-pound weight because that's kind of in the middle for me. So depending, I would recommend something that's kind of in the middle. For the yin stuff, I'm going to use a bolster. It's totally up to you what you feel like you need for those yin postures. You can have a block, pillow, blanket, etc. And just so you know, so I do have some other classes that are called Tone and Sculpt plus yin. And these are going to be similar to Yinyasa with weights. However, anything that says Yinyasa is more of a blended style where we kind of alternate and go back and forth between working stuff and resting stuff, as opposed to Tone and Sculpt all at the beginning and then yin at the end. And the nice thing is that, you know, you get some breaks in between all the working stuff, which depending on how you're feeling on any particular day, might feel a little bit nicer than kind of going big for a longer period of time and then resting. So let's get started. Make sure your props are handy. We'll come on down to our backs and do a little bit of warming up to start with some pelvic tilts. So if you've done my class ever before, you've probably done pelvic tilts at least recently. Here, one of my favorite movements here. So you're in a setup where you might be doing bridge pose, which we'll do in a little bit, but we're keeping our hips down and just moving the pelvis forward and back. So the low back lifts as the pelvis tilts forward, and then it presses down as we move in the opposite direction. And we're not going so far in the opposite direction that we would be lifting the hips, because again, that would be a bridge. So just tilting the pelvis. We're going to keep going with those pelvic tilts and add some arm movement to get the shoulders going a little bit. And we'll do two different variations on that arm movement, and they may feel different in your shoulders. So as we're tilting the pelvis forward and the low back is lifting, let's raise the arms up overhead and then lower down as the back goes down. That's the first variation. The second one is a wide reach up and down, like a snow angel. Just straight up and down, and then wide, and wide. Again, you certainly may feel some differences. I feel it more in my quote-unquote janky shoulder. It's a little bit clunkier on the wide reach than on the straight up and down. And that might be a bit of information, if that's the same for you, that you file away for future reference. Whenever you need to reach your arms up overhead, you have more than one way you can approach that that could feel better on your shoulder. Last round. Okay, so we're going to do one at a time. Grab hold of that weight. Doesn't matter which one you start with. I'm going to do left just because it's closer to the camera. And I'm going to bend that elbow. Elbow's down on the mat. Elbow is right by my waist. Other arm's just down resting. I'm going to press that weight up toward the ceiling. And then from that position, I'm going to let my shoulder blade kind of lift up and spread. And so the arm reaches up higher. And then shoulder blade back down. And you can kind of feel it poking into the mat. And then elbow down. Press up. We'll let that shoulder blade protract. And then go back down and elbow down. Let's keep going. If you're like me and you have a bendy wrist, I just noticed that I was letting my
collapse, so check in with your wrist, especially up there at the top. Let's do two more. Okay, then let's switch. Check in on the wrist. Maybe notice some differences from side to side. Two more. Last one. Okay. And then we're gonna take that weight and quote unquote ish, rest it atop of the hips. Keep your hands on it for support. We're gonna do two different things here. I'm gonna lift to bridge, right, with a little bit of load. So might feel a little bit, it's more challenging. And after we come down with the hips for bridge, we're gonna do a partial sit up, a crunch, a half roll up, whatever you wanna call it, but working our core a little bit from there. And one thing to think about when you're doing your bridges is where you place your feet can affect which muscles are working more. So the closer in you go, you might feel more glutes. The further out you go, you might feel more hamstrings. Feel free to play with that until it feels like you're working what you're hoping to work, right? And there's no one right answer, it just depends on what you want to get out of it. All right, so starting with the back, pressing down, right? Thinking about those pelvic tilts. So we want to be thinking, from that down position, like we're moving into more of a posterior tilt, a tuck, as we lift to bridge, holding that weight so it doesn't smack us in the face, lower down. And then we'll let that weight kind of slide up the legs while we do our little sit up, and then lower down. Bridge, and then sit up. Let's keep going. Take your time. And again, you can experiment with foot placement and see how that feels. Might also make a difference in how your sit-up feels, how close in or how far away your feet are. Two more. Last one. All right. Set that weight aside. Now it's time to take a little yin break. Yay! Again, that's the nice thing about this style, right? We can take a little rest in between our walking steps. So I'm going to use my bolster. You don't necessarily have to. We're going to take the right leg and cross it over the left for a more traditional reclined swan. That's the yin name for pigeon. It's the same pose, just different names for yin. I'm going to use the bolster to help me access that and just hold me up into the stretch more so I don't necessarily have to use my hands. You are more than welcome to use your hands. You are more than welcome to experiment with your prop usage. If you don't have a bolster, the opposite foot might be up on something, blocks, the wall, etc. And this more traditional setup for a reclined pigeon is intended to be more of a glute area stretch, so probably feeling that on the back of that right hip. Breathing. this same side for our pigeon setup, but take it into a different variation on the stretch. So if you've taken my class before, you may have done this. I call it fallen pigeon. So we're basically gonna just let our pigeon setup fall to the left. I'm gonna move the bolster. So pigeon setup kind of comes over to the left. Pigeon foot goes down the floor, and you can move your setup higher or lower depending on what you need. So I'm gonna see if I can grab hold of that pigeon ankle area with the closest hand, the left hand, and give a little pull in. As I'm pulling in, I'm resisting the pull on the leg by letting the leg push forward. And that just gives me a little bit more of the stretchy feeling, more front of the hip now instead of back of the hip. If you want to add a little side stretchy feeling, you can take your right arm and reach it overhead, which I think is nice. And breathe. Couple more breaths. All right, let's come out of that. Uncross, take a moment, let things settle. And then we'll do those two pigeon variations, swan variations on our other side. So we'll cross the left leg over. Again, you can just kind of pull in like you might normally do if you want to really knead it up, which I like. You can use a prop for help. Noticing perhaps some differences from side to side, which is completely normal. And, you know, our bodies are not symmetrical anyway from side to side. There's no need to be overly concerned with trying to make our sides equal in terms of strength and flexibility. It's nice to be aware of those things and just kind of keep track and, you know, maybe if we're feeling a little bit, say, weaker on one side, maybe we do a couple more reps or a heavier weight, etc. Or maybe if we're feeling a little bit tighter, we might hold a little bit longer on that side, etc. But again, there's no need to be overly concerned about those discrepancies because they're normal and we're all that way. Let's try that fallen pigeon variation, letting that pigeon setup fall over to the right. And you can move things higher or lower as needed. Pigeon foot's planted. I'm grabbing hold with my hand and pulling in, but letting the leg resist and move in the opposite direction. Left arm can reach over for a little side body action. Breathe.
drop the belly, cow. Exhale, tops of the feet down, round up. Caps. Moving through spinal extension and spinal flexion. So we're going to keep table as our base for the next little bit of work. I'm going to bring that weight a little closer up, right on the right side of the mat. It doesn't matter which side you start on because we are going to be moving it from side to side. So for the next little bit, we want to think more neutral spine, somewhere in the middle. It doesn't have to be exact, but just make sure we're not especially getting overly extended and kind of dumpy in the low back or the shoulders. All right, so see if you can feel some integrity in those areas. Tuck your toes, and we're gonna lift the knees to what's called bear position. You could call it hovering table, whatever you like. And then from bear, we'll step one foot at a time back into plank, and then step back into bear, and then in bear, my weight's on my right side. I'm gonna let my left hand grab it and slide over to the left. Left hand down, right hand grabs, passes it through over to the right. Back to bear, and then you can certainly take a rest in between by taking knees down, or if you're feeling good, you don't necessarily have to. So we'll do a few more. Bear, plank, bear, and then pass through, pass through. Maybe that rest in between. Let's keep going. And the thing we're thinking about with this pass-throughs is to try not to let the body sway too much, which is the hard part, of course. And now, weights rolling away the dangers. So maybe if you find that your weight rolls, maybe don't pass it through to the floor where it can go rolling away. Keep it on your mat so it's a little more stable. There we go. Now I do not have the budget for a video editor, so you get all of the little bloopers included. You're welcome. Pass through, pass through. I'm gonna do one more. Stay, wait. All right, let's move that weight aside. And again, we're gonna take a little break in child's pose. You can take it straight up, or maybe use a prop. Child's pose with a bolster is really nice. You may or may not have noticed heart rate getting faster, breath getting faster. So that's the other thing about this style is we have these opportunities in between working sets to slow things back down, take a rest.
Let's just take a few more breaths here. The only downside of this style, which I'm certainly feeling right now, is once you get to resting, sometimes that inertia kicks in and it's harder to get back up and move, but alas, we're gonna. Let's take one more breath. Okay. From here, I'm gonna move that bolster out of the way. And I'm gonna take this weight and have it over just off the mat on the left side so it's handy for the next thing that we'll use it for. And gonna come up into downward facing dog. Do a little bit of wiggling around. Pedaling the feet, maybe shake your head, move your hips a little bit. And then let's walk the feet forward and hang in a nice easy forward fold near the top of the mat. Knees might bend, you might sway a little bit, maybe grab elbows. And then let's come on up to standing. Take a moment up top to settle into your mountain pose. Finding foot placement that works best and feels balanced for your body. I like hip width. You can adjust that as needed. Inhale the arms overhead. Exhale, forward fold back down. Inhale, lift halfway, lengthen, flat back. Exhale, fold. Plant your hands, step into plank. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Okay, I'm gonna break with tradition a little bit today and do my left side first, because I think it'll be easier for you to see. So, left foot forward. Let's bring the back knee down and then come upright in this low lunge. And again, upright, instead of being really far forward in our lunge, a little bit more just like a half kneeling position. We're gonna do some moving around from this position. Balance might be a little bit of a challenge. You can widen your stance a little bit for help. Pad that back knee with a towel or a blanket if you feel like you want some extra padding. All right, hands reach behind the head, elbows wide. We're gonna start with a shifted back position. So we'll push back, straighten that left leg, flex the foot, and turn the torso to the left, and then come back forward. And then we're going to turn to the right, and as we turn, let the back shin angle in, and then do a little reach forward from that position, kind of like side angle with the knee down, and then we'll come back upright, moving between those two. All right, straighten. There's where balance is really an issue. And forward. And then turn and reach. And back forward. A couple more. That one I gotta do slowly. Okay. So next time we're in this turn to the left position with a straightish leg and toes up. We're gonna stay facing this direction and take hands down and over to that side. And now feeling some IT band area, kind of outside of the thigh sensation. Gonna stay here and do toes down and toes up. Really work the toes, kind of scrunch them and spread them back and forth as you're moving your foot. One more. Okay, let's lunge back forward. Walk your hands with you. We're gonna keep the right knee down and move into a knee down side plank on that right side. So the right shin angles out for balance like a kickstand.
left foot steps to the back of the mat. All right, take a moment to just kind of get your setup and make sure that we're feeling some integrity through this shoulder. We're not just dumping down, okay? Bring that weight a little closer in towards your right hand, and we're gonna be grabbing hold with the left hand. So, gonna start with one little sequence and then add on. So we're gonna reach that weight up toward the ceiling, check the wrist, and then lift up off of the hand so you're more kneeling. And as I come up, I'm gonna rotate my arm in and then back down with the hand. And that's a little trickier than it might look. And then weight reaches down. So we'll do a few of those and then we'll add. Reach the weight up, lift up, rotates in. And then hand down, weight down. Okay, we're gonna add next time. So from here, this kneeling position, I'm gonna take this back foot and step it forward. So now I'm in a lunge. And then I'm gonna take my back foot and step it up. So I'm in just a standing position, still reaching that weight up, trying to stabilize. Step the right foot back again, knee down. Step your left foot back where it was, and then we'll take the hand down, and then lower down. Let's do a couple more of those. Rotate in, step forward, step forward. Step back, step back. Carefully come down. Reach that weight down. Let's do one more. And this other hand can help you balance. All right. So just kind of move that weight aside. You can put it on the right side since it'll be there when we need it. For the opposite side, step into plank. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Right foot forward. Back knee down. Low lunge. Come upright. Really upright, more kneeling. Okay, take a moment, maybe widen your stance, pad the knee as needed. Hands behind the head. All right, we'll shift back and straighten with a flexed foot as we turn to the right. And then lunge face forward. And then we'll let the back shin angle in while we turn to the left and reach down toward that front leg. And then back forward. Let's do a few more. Okay, the next time we're facing over to the right with our straight leg flexed foot, we'll take our hands down over to that side, see what we feel, and then we'll work that foot. Toes down, toes up, point and flex, work the toes. Couple more. All right. Walk things back forward, and then we'll get set up in our knee down side plank variation on the left side. Shin angles out, right foot steps back. Take a moment, adjust your setup as needed. Bring that weight a little closer in towards your left hand. Right, check in on that supporting shoulder. Okay, and we'll grab that weight with the right hand, and we'll reach it up. Carefully lift off of the hand to more of a kneeling position. Arm rotates in, and then we'll go back down, and then weight down. All right, we'll try a few of those before adding. All
from that kneeling position, that right foot steps forward, left foot steps forward, so we're standing, left foot steps back, knee down, right foot steps back, carefully, lower down, right down. Let's do a couple more. Last one. That weight aside, step into plank, inhale, and lower to your belly, exhale. Okay, make sure things are out of the way. Let's take a little chest stretch from here, left cactus arm out to the side, roll over, head might be up, head might be down, top leg can do what it wants to do. Side, cactus arm, side roll. Let's roll down, and we'll kind of stay in restful yin territory for a little bit, and we're going to multitask, because we can. So, base is sphinx, so we'll be here for a few minutes, and we'll do one thing with one leg at a time for a little bit. So, I'll start with the left again, because it's closest to the camera, taking that leg forward into like a frog position. Feel free to shift on your mat for comfort, for padding, etc. And you can always decrease the amount of the sphinx part by taking your elbows more forward. Let's take a little bit of time here and breathe. Definitely, again, kind of feeling that heart rate get higher, breath get faster during the working portions, which is good for us, right? Frankly, I don't get a lot of cardio otherwise, so I'm always grateful when I can feel a slight bit of that while I'm on the mat. And you could always use your props to help you feel supported in this position as well, right? Any yin posture props can give a little bit of support to. Let's take just a couple more breaths with the frog leg that we have. And then let's go ahead and switch to the opposite side for our frog leg. Again, if you need to lessen the sphinx, you can move more forward, maybe use a prop to help prop you up. Sure your inner knee feels comfy. Sometimes this can irritate those bony areas.
weight is handy near the top of your mat, you may or may not want your yin props near the top of your mat for what's to come. Keep that in mind. Okay, downward facing dog. Step or hop forward to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold. Okay, feet hip width. From here, from our fold position, bring your weight right in front of your feet. Grab hold of the bells of your dumbbell. Bend your knees a touch. And we're gonna stand up from here. And then we're going to go back down. So my intent for this is it to be a Romanian deadlift. So we're going to bend the knees, but not as much as we might in a regular deadlift. And as we're lowering, we're keeping the weight close to our legs. So kind of feel like they're sliding down. And we're going to send our butts back, like we're trying to shut a door. And then when you feel your hammies, say, okay, I see what you're doing here. Stop there and then press back up. Let's do a few more. Last one. Okay. From here, bring that weight up to your chest. And get your left leg somewhere in tree pose position, standing on the right leg. Okay, take your weight up. As we bend the elbows so the weight goes behind our head, detach your tree leg so those tree leg muscles have to work a touch more while we do our little tricep curl there, and then foot back to the leg and weight up. Let's keep going. From tree, bring your weight to your chest, and then we're going to step that left foot back and out of touch to find a position that'll get us into goddess. Okay, so we had to kind of sit into it, sit as low as you dare. We're going to do a curl here, curl the weight down, reach it back up, and then go ahead and straighten your legs. Squat back down, do a curl, and then back up. Let's keep going. See one more. Okay. So from here, I'm gonna bend the front knee and pivot that back foot in. So I'm in more of a warrior one like position. And then I'm gonna grab that weight just in the left hand and lower down so I'm at a little bit of an angle in warrior one so that I can do some rows with that left arm. So the elbow comes up by your side. Try to keep your chest facing down so you're not rotating while you lift that weight. Do two more. All right, carefully set that weight aside. Take your hands down and let's straighten that right leg so we're in a pyramid-like position. And you could have a prop somewhere to reach for if the floor is hard to reach, which it can be, especially if you have long legs. think. So back leg is gonna come forward and you can kind of think like you're doing a curtsy, reach behind, and then we'll sit and walk that top leg over more. And this is shoelace, like cow face in more traditional yoga. Same pose, different name. And I'm not gonna bother with the arm stretch, just keep it to the hip stretch. You can sit on a prop if that makes life easier, which it certainly does for a lot of us. You might use a prop out in front of you to rest on in some manner, and you can certainly experiment with that in lots of different ways. And maybe you start one way where you're a little bit higher and gradually get lower, etc. But regardless, we'll take just a little bit of time here.
Minute or so.
There's any number of ways you could choose to transition back so we can get to our other side. Make sure your stuff is out of the way. You can kind of reverse your steps a little bit. If not, I always like to do that because it feels like a puzzle that I'm working through. So we kind of came down through a curtsy position from pyramid, etc. You can step back and you can certainly flow chaturanga, etc. or not. Alright, you can always choose just to go right back to down dog. Once you're in down dog, a little bit of wiggling. Step or hop forward to the top of your mats. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold. Draw that weight right in front of your feet. Feet hip width-ish. Grab your weights, come up to standing. Right, and again, we'll try our Romanian deadlifts. Trying to think hip hinge, so we're like shutting the door behind us as we bring the weight and kind of slide it down and up. Thank you.
to your chest. Right foot goes into tree pose position. Take your weight up. All right. So again, as we bend the elbows, we'll detach the tree leg and let it be more active. Weight goes up, foot goes back to the standing leg. Let's keep going. My neighbor Stog likes this one. Can you hear? Let's do a couple more. Okay, from tree, bring the weight to your chest. Tree foot steps back and out so that we can get set up in our goddess pose-like position. All right, go ahead and sit a little lower into it. Feet are turned out. And then we'll do a curl. Let the weight reach down and back up, and then come out of the squat. Keep going. Do two more. Last one. Okay. And then we'll let things pivot forward into more of a warrior one base position. Weight in the right hand. Lower a bit for some rows here with the right arm. Try to keep your chest facing down and really squeeze that shoulder blade in as you row. Couple more. All right, carefully set that weight out of the way. Straighten the left leg to find pyramid, or at least something resembling. Okay, and then we'll move through a kind of a curtsy position to get us down to the mat for shoelace. Left leg is on top, wrap as you are able. You can adjust for comfort, of course. Maybe sit on something. Maybe a prop out in front of you to rest arms, head on, etc. All right. Take a few minutes here. Breathe. Thank you.
few more breaths here in shoelace. Transition back to down dog in any way that you see fit. If you're like me and kind of like the challenge of reversing your steps and kind of finishing your puzzle, you might plant your left foot again, move through that curtsy position to step back. And again, you can go right to down dog or you can flow one last time. Take a moment in down dog, wiggle what you want to wiggle. Right, we've got one more bit of work to do for this class. And we won't use a weight this time, just body weight. So we're going to attempt to move toward dolphin, back and forth, down dog toward dolphin, by bending the elbows but not letting them splay wide. So keeping them in line with the arms so that it's more of a tricep action and then back up. Back and forth. The more you bend, the harder it is to get back up, right? So you can keep it small. A couple more. And then we'll end with elbows on the mat. Dolphin, take a moment. And then lengthen your dolphin by moving your feet and or your elbows until you're in more of a forearm plank. You can do clasped hands, it doesn't matter what you do with your hands. And let's do some twisting of the lower body from side to side. Breathe. Almost there. One more round. Woo! Drop your knees. All right, gonna have a nice yin stretch from there. I'm gonna make it sort of a hybrid kind of action. Puppy pose, but with a tricep stretch since we did some tricep work. So, traditional puppy pose, chest lowering, hands forward, etc. So, this time, you can kind of get that as your base, and then elbows down, forehead down, and then prayer hands can reach for your upper back, or your hands can reach for your upper back. Elbows stay forward and kind of tug back until you feel that tricep stretch. Certainly remove the tricep portion and make it more of just an upper back area stretch. And you could always experiment with propping, of course. Take something underneath your head.
Okay. Let's come up onto that. And we'll come to seated for one last yin pose before Shavasana. Straddle. Some people call it dragonfly. Seated wide-legged fold. And you could use a prop somewhere out in front to rest on. Don't necessarily have to, depending. Things can be propped up in any number of ways, depending on your floor surface. Of course, your pillows, blankets, etc., bolsters may slide. So just be mindful of that. Let your breath slow down any amount more. That's where you're starting to wind things down. No more work. We made it. Couple more breaths here. All right, let's come on up and we'll come down for our Shavasana. I'm gonna use the bolster underneath my legs because it feels wonderful. Feel free to experiment with your propping as well.
And or your positioning. It doesn't have to be flat on your back if that's not comfy. Find something that works for you. Settle in and close your eyes. Let everything go. Even your breath, just let it be natural. Let it be effortless. And let yourself rest. start to deepen the breath and wiggle fingers and toes. Circle wrists and ankles. And reaching arms overhead. Nice long stretch. Hug the knees in and rock. Rolling over to one side and resting there. And gently press up to a comfortable seat. Take a moment, let yourself settle, notice how things are feeling, notice your breathing. Thank you so much for joining me for this Yinyasa with weights, and I look forward to practicing with you again soon. Have a great day.